Nikki, the road to the championship's become a little less crowded, but there still isn't enough room for both of these teams. Which team will become a casualty of the second round in this game between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Kansas Jayhawks?
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Jayhawks should be in for a tough one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First of all, set good interior screens to free up your big men on the block. Look to the inside first. Second of all, get busy battling for the boards. Winning teams always rebound well. And lastly, play as a five-man unit defensively. Have rhythm. Be ready to rotate. Help one another on penetration.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. That's just great hustle and great defense of the steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Number three takes the pass, looking for a good shot. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Looking for a good shot. He makes a nice shot fake. The shooting guard takes the feed. And they get the turnover.
Applying lots of pressure, Brad, and looking for the steal as well.
Perfectly executed. He shoots from left of the circle. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Fed the low block. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. He lets it fly. He nails the shot. Inside. Entry pass in the paint for the bucket. And off the mark. Number 15 is eager and excited to compete.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Number one gets the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Trying to pack it inside. Tries to get the D to bite.
Double team now, bad angle.
For two. Doesn't go. He keeps the dribble as they reset. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. The power forward with the ball. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
Here's the replay.
He'll regroup the offense. Watch out, 5-second call approaching. He tries the three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
Inside, takes the pass in the paint. Goes up for two, and in and out. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Can we get him the ball, though?
The crowd loves blocked. Number 41 gets the pass. Number three steals the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Defensively doing a great job down there. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
The rim and no good. spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
These three balls are hitting from everywhere.
That's right, Brad. I saw one come from the hot dog stand not too long ago.
For two, he's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team, get in the flow.
Here's a double team. He tries the fall away, way off target.
Hey, Brad, a stop here will definitely raise the decibel level.
On the outside, from the top of the circle, knocks it down. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Fakes a jumper. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Great anticipation defensively. Up and inside.
From left of the circle.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
Moving it around the perimeter on the inside. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Good job defensively.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
The Jayhawks go to the line for the first time in this game. Got to make the freebies. Second shot, no good. Working it around the perimeter. Trying to draw some contact. Contact causes the shot to come off. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Tries for two.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
On the outside. Number one takes it away. Here they go into the break. Trying to draw the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
It's a hoop and a foul.
He showed good concentration on possession, Brad.
The Jayhawks are looking rattled. They really got to get themselves together right now.
Hey, partner, you really are sharp. That's a great observation. If they don't turn things around in a hurry, it could snowball into something much worse.
He sinks it. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He takes the rebound.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And a momentary look from three-point land. And the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
And he'll kick it back outside. From right in the circle, he might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Shot clock is dead. Big man spins down the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
There they come with a double team to stop it.
Oh, what a strip, Brad.
They're punishing the rim with those misses from three-point lane.
Yeah, Brad. No one seems to have found the touch.
At halftime, the Golden Eagles are up by four. This one's too close to call here at the end of the first. Dick, do you have a highlight of the half?
This dunk right here dazzled the folks in the cheap seats, baby. I hope we see more of the same in the second half, Brad.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Kansas is practically handing the ball over to the opposing team like it's a Christmas present or something right now, Dick.
Hey, any team would gladly receive this kind of nice gesture. I bet they're not getting anything but a mouthful of criticism from their coaching staff.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. You betcha.
You don't see plays like this every day.
Cross court. Steals a pass. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the block.
He rejects it. Moving it around the perimeter. High post player flashing. Went away from the post and goes the other way. And the ball goes out of play. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
He fires from long range. Goes. Gave it up. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Off the rim and no good. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Foul charge. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
The shooting guard receives the pass. He's got the post flashing if he wants it.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Takes away the pass. Stolen pass.
Hey, he read his eyes on that one, Brad.
He's got some room. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Finger roll. The shot from the baseline. Dickey's simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
He fakes the shot.
There's the trap.
Number 22 comes up with it. From way outside. That's good. He's going to see this guy to sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living a nightmare, Brad.
He shoots from outside.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
He looks at the hoop. He fires from long range. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Picks off the pass. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Rims out for two. Up, easy one. Here's the drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
The center handles the pass. Can't get the shot to go. It's good.
We didn't see that again, Brad.
Kicks it out. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. He'll kick it back outside.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He attempts a jump hook. Doesn't go. Number 32 with the fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Looking for a good shot. Defense giving some room. Buries the deuce. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
He knocks down another bucket, Dick.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a
with great anticipation for the rejection. Oh, he's having fun with the opponents, Dick.
He sure is, but he better make sure that he doesn't cross the line.
High post flashes for the ball handler. Takes away the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Jumped in front to take it away. The power forward receives the ball. Marquette are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Intercepted. The point guard handles the feed. Picks off the lazy pass. For the bucket. The layup.
Hey, don't let these guys get in too much of a rhythm.
Can they regroup in time, you think?
Let's see what happens.
There's a double team waiting there. Stolen ball. He attempts the three.
Oh, you gotta knock those down. Great screen, but no go.
They work it back to the outside. He lets it fly. He's definitely hogging the ball like you hog the microphone.
Hey, sure he is. I can hear snorting from here.
Look at that spacing.
Ten on the shot clock. In the post. Gets it back out with the big shot. Off target.
Let's see what happens here.
A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
They'll work it around the arc. The ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Looking for a good shot. I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And the clock stopped with a foul. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you gotta protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy, I love that. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Number one goes to the line for the 1-1. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Hits the second. The lead is 9.
9 is fine, Brad. They have to keep their composure and take good shots. Dump it inside.
He lets it go. He gets that one to fall. And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Second one is good. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
He shoots from left of the circle.
You need to create as many possessions as possible, so keep falling.
Number 22 going to the line for the first time tonight. Up and in. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
No doubt. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
He dials long distance. Off the rim and no good. Number 24 makes a great move to draw the foul. He is going to the line. Misses the first shot. He misses it. Collects the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
Up and inside.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. They're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Gets it back out. They work the perimeter. The Golden Eagles have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Golden Eagles graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.